making them. They're telling them, no, cut.
No, you need to do this.
You need to do this. Look how that young girl was like stretched like this.
That's so inappropriate. The thing is that we always try and protect our children from people's evil eyes and perverted eyes.
Yes.
Like, you know, pedophiles and these people that are always like, you know, they want to abuse children or they have these dirty thoughts.
Yeah.
You always want to protect your children from that. You want to protect your children from harm. You want to keep them away from harm. You are pushing your child into this industry where they're doing these things and people are looking at them in a bad way. You're okay with that? You think this is normal?
Yeah.
That's just, I mean, as a parent, I feel bad for those children.
Way of Life SQ, keeping it 100.
I was saying that.
Okay, go ahead.
Welcome back to my YouTube channel.
You have to say assalamu alaikum, welcome back to my YouTube channel.
I ready to
no, say it once again. More.
I'm gonna say that again.
Okay, say it. Ready? Go.
May Allah bless you.
Alright, well, yeah. That's our intro. Alright guys, so here is an exclusive Parents React to the Netflix Cuties trailer. We're going to watch the trailer together, inshallah, and we're just going to see what our initial reaction is with me and my wife, inshallah, and just let's take it from there. Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's turn this on. And if you want to speak, just put it next to your mic, okay? Bismillah. Okay. He's ironing right here. Just straighten it.
She's trying to copy.
Yeah, she's trying to like, they're doing the challenge. But notice how that she was whitewashed already to make her feel inferior, the quality of hair. They're like, look how she's dressing.
Goodness.
She's supposed to be 11.
Wow.
She's like stuck in this cultural Senegalese home. They're going to do Rukia on her. Watch.
You know how much like, you know, culture and richness there is in this. And they're trying to make it look like it's backwards.
Backwards, yeah. There's so much culture in Senegalese.
This is, I'm assuming, French, right?
Yes.
Yeah, they're always trying to make Islam look bad.
Yeah.
They're banning
Think about
hijab,
like all the laws
niqab.
They have. Look at this.
Yeah.
Look at this, what they're doing. Look at this. Look at that. And look. The grandma's going to be doing dumb on her to make sure that she has no jinn in her. Look at this. She wants to be free, and they're holding her back.
This is like inappropriate. Those boys were like 14, 15.
No, they're way older.
Well, I think they're probably going to make them look like that, but these girls are like inappropriately dressed.
And Netflix wants to drop this on September. Put it next to your mouth this week. They want to drop this on September 9th. That's when they want to do this about it. So what's your initial thoughts about this entire film?
I think that these children are being exploited. Like, look at what they're wearing. Like, are their parents okay with them being highly sexualized?
What parents would be okay? Look, there's a tripod over here, go back.
I mean, she was wearing like a crop top.
Yeah.
And one of the
She's
girls,
like 11. And you know they're Muslims, by the way. She's supposed to be Muslim, yeah?
Is she actually a Muslim?
Yes,
or?
yes.
Wow.
She's not just playing a Muslim in the movie. She actually is a Muslim. And look, we have children going out. Hey, sweetheart, do not go around us. Do not go around us. So we actually have, obviously, children over here. We're parents to two beautiful girls. And, like, think about this, right? They're someone's daughters. They're someone's girls. Like, what's going on in the mind of a parent who's allowing their children to jump on movies like this?
I mean, it's really inappropriate. Like, even let's putting the Muslim girl aside, even the other girls,
stay over there,
the other French girls, I just feel really bad for them because
go over there right now.
Look at what they're making them wear, what they're making them do, the suggestive dance moves that people like Cardi B do.
Yeah.
Those are grown-ass women who can decide what they want to do in life.
Yeah.
But they're making these girls act like that in front of the camera.
Wait, say that again? They're making them. They're telling them, no, cut.
No, you need to do
you
this.
You need to do this. Look how that young girl was like stretched like this.
That's so inappropriate.
Papu, like when we have our daughters, even in our own house, when she's wearing something, we're like, listen, sweetheart, you have to close
your legs. Yeah, and pull your dress down.
Pull your shorts down. Sit down with your legs closed, right?
Because this is how they learn. They learn at home.
But it's like,
I can imagine that
director, them doing that scene saying, cut, no, sweetheart. Do this. Lie down and do this. Like, why are the directors of this movie making sure they're making it more exploitive, right? More suggestive, more sexual.
I mean, my thing is that the parents of these children, like all of them, like they don't find this like bad. They don't find this weird. Like,
so
my child is
like,
doing
do you
something.
Feel like, okay, leaving the Muslim thing aside, right?
I think
do you
any
feel like
parent,
parent. Do you think like the parents sold out?
I don't want to say they sold out, but I feel like in order to propel their child in this industry, they've allowed the child to do things that are A, un-Islamic,
yes.
B,
even
go,
Islam aside,
yeah,
right?
Leaving Islam aside, and B, like things that are just inappropriate.
Yeah.
Like, it's like you want the fame so bad, you're going to allow your child to do that.
So do you feel like they sold, like the parent, not a Muslim parent, but the parent in general, do they feel like they've sold their morality, their values, their standards
for
fame? For a quick launch in the right direction?
I mean,
because of how many roles this is going to get their kids.
More than likely, yes. But my thing is that we always try and protect our children from people's evil eyes and perverted eyes.
Yes.
Like, you know, pedophiles and these people that are always like, you know, they want to abuse children or they have these dirty thoughts. You always want to protect your children from that. You want to protect your children from harm. You want to keep them away from harm. You are pushing your child into this industry where they're doing these things and people are looking at them in a bad way and you're okay with that? You think this is normal?
Yeah.
That's just, I mean, as a parent, I feel bad for those children.
Yeah, because the children don't know any better.
Yeah.
The parents know. Yeah.
The parents know. A child will do, if you ask them to do something for the camera or act in a certain way, they'll do it because they're being told to do it.
Yeah.
And think
about this, right? And this goes back to like that Disney culture where parents put their children into it, right?
Propel them in for the
And guess what? When they get older, they have so much resentment towards them. Look at Macaulay Culkin. He hates his parents. His parents have a bad relationship. Look at Miley Cyrus with her parents and all that. They pushed her into this industry when the child is not even interested in themselves. And some would even suggest that they like pimped out their children.
So the thing is, even grown-ass like women are saying they were abused, they were groomed, they were this.
Yeah.
So what do you think is happening to these children?
Yeah. So check this out. And you know,
and
I found out that the co-director or producer of this movie, someone sent a comment. I don't know the validation of how valid this is, but I haven't verified it. But they said that he was charged with sexual misconduct for child abuse or something like that. He was charged for that, something of that nature. And someone else put another comment out there too. And the cool thing is, I find this cool, that it's not like people are offended for Muslims, like, oh my God, why are you portraying another Muslim?
It's the children. It's irrespective of a Muslim child or not. Children in general, this is not right.
Go back.
Yeah, it's any child is not right.
Thank you.
It's inappropriate to be putting children in these situations.
And what I appreciate the most about this, what I appreciate is like people again are not, we're not like their message might have been trying to basically whitewash the Muslim culture, make Muslims feel inferior. Now look at that girl. She had to straighten her hair to make it look white, right? To do all these things like that. Maybe that was the agenda of the French because they tend to do these things with Muslims, as you mentioned. You know, they banned the niqab, they banned the hijab at a certain age for young girls, right? So they're trying to portray Muslims in an incorrect way. Okay, that's fine. Okay, do you. But it was Urta, it was like reverse Uno. It basically became against them and how they're supporting a pedophile sort of ring. It's like they're grooming children. And so many non-Muslims are upset of the fact that, hey, why are you doing this? There was this Christian sister who commented on my videos and she was saying, I'm not even a Muslim and I'm offended by this. Like, that's not...
But like, I don't want to come across as like, oh, people in, you know, the government in France, but I know they're really, really against... Like, you know, the hijab.
Yeah, they are,
against,
though. That's a fact.
Against, you know, anything that's Islamic. Like, girls who go to school, they can't wear a hijab. I mean, I've read stories. I've spoken to people online that have said that they wear wigs.
Yeah.
Just because they don't want to show their real hair, but they want to get an education. And the only way they can do that is by wearing a wig and going to school.
What kind of
now, that's their jihad. Like,
yeah,
that's
their
struggle.
Yep.
But the thing is, like, they want to make Islam like seem oppressive, seem like old school, and by doing this, it just there's so many other videos that, you know, are French, and it's the same sort of thing, the same propaganda.
Yeah.
You know, always trying to make the, you know, you have to leave Islam and that's how you become
liberated
and become normal.
Yeah, they never portray a video where, like, there would never be a video where a movie where the girl is struggling and she discovers Islam. That would never happen, right? Because that's a real thing that's happening and changing people's lives. So here's the thing, right? And this is for a lot of parents out there. So you're like, okay, SQ, okay, Iman, what do we do now, right? Our children are watching this. It's on the Disney Channel. Watch the Disney Channel. It's all about singing, dancing, and becoming social influencers, right? Our children are being into these things. They're watching YouTube videos of other people doing things like that. What do we do? Where's the Islamic voice within this? And my wife, after watching this, and we've been thinking about it for some time, we've decided to start our own thing with our own children, right? Our own pretend play. Why don't you tell them a little bit about what we want to do?
So the girls are both into like Frozen and stuff like that. So whenever they do mention things, we try and like give it more of an Islamic like perception. So like we say, oh, you know, we don't do magic. We make dua to Allah and Allah makes things, you know, happen for us.
Yeah.
So we try and change their perception on what the movie says. And obviously they're at that age where they do pretend play and stuff.
Yeah.
So we do pretend play with them and we bring Islam into it. Like everything is more of an Islamic perspective.
So for example, for one of our pretend plays, and you guys are going to see this, I'm still debating. I think I'm going to start a new YouTube channel for children, right? And it's going to be my daughters, Dua and Haya, doing pretend play and educating your children, our children. They're not your children. They're my children too. Your children are my little children as well. SubhanAllah. Right? And we want them to get like real Islamic guidance. So I want them to see, instead of watching someone who's not a Muslim do pretend play and learn something that's haram, right? They're going to watch our children do pretend play. And we're going to make sure, I'm going to make sure, my wife's going to make sure that there's an Islamic message behind every single video, right? So they're going to learn how to give dawah to each other, how to teach your children how to give dawah to other children, and how to become influencers within the Islamic sphere. And when your children go to school, how they can give dawah to other kids, right? That's essentially what the goal is going to be doing. First, it's going to be centered around a lot of Frozen stuff because our daughters, they're into that
That's
stuff.
It. We can
we
only
don't
do
want to change that.
Yeah, we
you
can
know
only
what I mean?
Do what they
so,
like.
So, for example, like the first episode of it, and stay tuned for this. If you have little children, tell me in the comment section below if that's something you guys would be interested in, right? So, the first episode, or it's going to be called like Frozen Pretend Play, Elsa and Anna Accept Islam. That's literally going to be the first video. And we're going to teach the children how someone could accept Islam and everything like that. And from that on, Elsa and Anna are going to be Muslims, right? And you're just going to be seeing the journey of our children into Islam. And that's going to be pretend play, Elsa and Anna. We're going to be teaching them about a lot of cool stuff. So stay tuned for that. That's a major announcement. A Muslim pretend play channel, right? A Muslim pretend play channel. That's going to be super fun, educational, entertaining for your children to watch and to learn from as well too, inshallah. But that's essentially the video. Anything last comments that you want to say?
No, yeah, just watch out for the videos. I won't be in them as much.
She's probably going to be like,
I'm going to be Olaf. He's going to be Olaf.
I'm going to be Olaf.
And I'll be behind
the scenes. Reordered my costume. I'm going to be Olaf. And Olaf is going to be the character that guides them the correct way, right? It's going to be that special character that when they're doing something wrong, Olaf is going to be the character that guides them correctly. Guys, I appreciate you watching this. Tell me in the comment section below how you appreciated or liked me getting my wife. It takes a lot for me to convince her. So, you know, make sure you drop an extra like for this one so that she sees that this is a lot of love that she's getting for that. If you haven't watched the last video about my reaction to this, because I realized I didn't react as a parent. I just reacted as like a regular dude, a Muslim. Watch that video over here too. That's pretty good. Check out some of my latest videos, which are right over here. And should they subscribe?
If they want to.
If they want to, we don't really care. Okay, so say Assalamu alaikum now.
Assalamu alaikum, back to my YouTube channel.
Say it's time to say bye now. Say Assalamu alaikum, bye-bye. So may Allah bless
bye. May Allah bless you.
Give him a kiss. Yeah, mashallah. That's it, guys.